Welcome back, and I hope you are ready for an adrenaline-fueled showdown. This is the ruthless, cutthroat game show that has all the top medical experts talking, and I'm here to put you through your paces to see if you will be crowned the next medical legend. The rules of this game are very simple. There will be 8 multiple choice questions, and your score at the end of the test will determine your overall rank and see whether you will be crowned a medical legend. So if you have what it takes, get your pen and paper ready and let's play Medical Legend. Question 1. Now, to ease you into this, we'll start with a straightforward question. Review this ECG and calculate the ventricular rate. Here are your 4 possible answers. Remember that only one of them is correct. Is the correct answer 100 beats per minute, 72 beats per minute, 66 beats per minute, or 78 beats per minute? The correct answer is 72 beats per minute. Well done to those that got this right. To those that didn't, you can calculate the ventricular rate by counting the number of R waves in the rhythm strip and multiplying them by 6. Let's move on to the next question. Question 2. You are asked to review the ECG of a 60-year-old male in the surgical pre-assessment clinic. Please review the ECG and confirm the diagnosis. And here are your 4 possible answers for question 2. Is the correct answer septal myocardial infarction, left bundle branch block, sinus tachycardia, or right bundle branch block? Have you made your decision? The correct answer is right bundle branch block. And to confirm right bundle branch block, there must be a broad QRS complex in both V1 and V6, with an RSR complex in V1, and in V6 there must be an S wave with a duration equal to or greater than 1 small square. Well, as we move through this episode, the pressure is mounting, like the blood pumping through the aorta. Are you going to be able to keep your cool? Let's find out. Let's move on to question 3. A 60-year-old is found to have an irregular pulse. An ECG is performed. Please review the ECG and confirm the diagnosis. And here are your 4 possible answers. Remember that only one of them is correct. Is the correct answer atrial fibrillation, sinus arrest, Mobitz type 2, or Mobitz type 1? The correct answer is Mobitz type 1. This was a tricky ECG, but it is this section here which will have helped you to confirm the diagnosis. A progressively lengthened PR interval until a P wave is produced, but the impulse is not conducted to the ventricles. If you didn't get this correct, don't worry, this is a challenge in ECG. Learn from this and next time you'll spot it. Okay, it's time to move on. Question 4. A 50-year-old male presents with shortness of breath and palpitations. An ECG is performed. Please review the ECG and confirm the diagnosis. And here are your four possible answers. Atrial fibrillation. Ventricular tachycardia. AVNRT. Left bundle branch block. The correct answer is AVNRT. So to confirm the diagnosis, you can see that this is a regular narrow complex tachycardia with visible QRS and T waves, but P waves are not visible. They are likely buried within the QRS complex, and this is typical for an atrioventricular nodal reentry tachycardia, or AVNRT. This was another tricky ECG, but this is medical legend, and this is how legends are made. Let's move on. Question 5. A 40-year-old presents with chest pain after a viral respiratory illness. An ECG is performed. Please review this and confirm the diagnosis. Here are your four possible answers. Remember, only one of them is correct. Is this a left bundle branch block, pericarditis, Wellens syndrome, or inferior myocardial infarction? The correct answer is pericarditis. The ECG here shows saddle-shaped ST elevation, which is present in almost all territories. This is typical for pericarditis. Let's move on to question 6. You examine a patient and hear a late diastolic murmur with an opening snap. Please review the ECG and select the diagnosis. Here are your four possible answers. Left axis deviation, Wellens syndrome, P mitrale, or sinus bradycardia. The correct answer is P mitrale. This is confirmed by having a P wave that has two peaks separated by at least one small square and having a duration that is prolonged greater than three small squares. Okay, we are now at the penultimate question. The stakes are high. Try to stay calm. Question 7. Review the following ECG and confirm the diagnosis. Here are your four possible answers. Atrial fibrillation, right axis deviation, sinus tachycardia, or third degree heart block. I don't know about you, but I can really feel the tension building. The correct answer is atrial fibrillation. This is confirmed by the irregularly irregular rhythm and the absence of P waves. Okay, we are now moving to the final question. Only one question separates you from legendary status. Your final patient is waiting. Question 8. A 20-year-old female presents with shortness of breath, palpitations, and dizzy spells. An ECG is performed. Please confirm the diagnosis. Is the correct answer atrial fibrillation, atrioventricular nodal reentrant tachycardia, atrioventricular reentry tachycardia, or right bundle branch block? Well, I am on the edge of my seat. This tension is giving me anxiety. The correct answer is, for medical legendary status, AVRT. This is the correct answer because there is irregular narrow complex tachycardia with retrograde P waves. A special congratulations to everyone that's managed to get this far through this episode of Medical Legend. Tally up your results and let's see what your ranking is. So for 3 correct answers, you will score the ranking of medical student. If you managed to get 4 correct answers, you've achieved the ranking of house officer. If you got 5 correct answers, you're a specialist registrar. 6 correct answers gives you the ranking of MD. If you got 7 correct answers, you are a professor. But only those who scored 8 correct answers can claim the title of medical legend. Congratulations to those that have achieved the top score. You are truly amazing. Go out and tell your family and friends. Get them to buy a plaque commemorating what a genius you are. Please let me know what your scores are in the comments below. And if you enjoyed watching this, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell, and you'll be notified when more great shows like this become available. Thanks for stopping by. I will see you in the next episode.